Just when I thought it couldn't get any crazier or worse, Chase Bank just goes into your account and is like, you know what? You don't need any of these accounts. We're going to go ahead and cancel all of your accounts, all your credit cards. Yeah, because we kind of don't like the way you are. I'm sorry, you voted for who? Ooh, hold on. Let me check and see what time it is. Hold on. Looks like I have another appointment. I'm sorry. Was that too soon? That was 4 days ago. Oh, I'm sorry. You also said that you're a general. Oh, that was nice. You served in our military. Yeah, sorry. There's nothing we can do about it. And I really wanted to run the story last night. I was going to do two videos. But, you know, when the one guy's like, Bitcoin's going to zero, I'm like, all right, you come first. Chase Bank cancels General Mike Flynn's credit cards. And if you don't believe me, believe Twitter or believe General Flynn. I could not imagine, you know, people are like canceling my stuff. I'm like, I would like to post this and tell everyone. We are closing your credit cards. After careful consideration, we decided to close your credit cards on September 18th, 2021, because of continuing the relationship creates possible, like, problems. We just don't like you. Also, you may receive additional account closings, right? Any other accounts? Yeah, welcome to communism, socialism, feudalism. There we go. We're going with feudalism on this one. And I'll tell you, it's just gut-wrenching. Me, serving in the military, Desert Shield, Desert Storm, and then seeing what politicians do and what people do, I'm like, do you see what's going on? I mean, I see what's going on, and it's kind of frightening, especially when, cue the fire, Fed's officials, former Fed officials, come out and say, we are in threat of another financial crisis. Well, it's currently happening, and I'm going to show you. Oh, bravo, you're just so doomed. I forgot to cue the fire. So doom and gloom. Really? Have you turned on CNN? Have you turned on your TV? Man, I'm just telling you, these dominoes are all set up and they're getting ready to fall. Former Fed official warns of urgent threat. Okay. Fed official. He's very well aware of politics. I'm sure he got a call from Jerome. Says urgent threat of another financial crisis. Well, why would you say that, Don? Huh? Do you see something that we all don't? And actually, you guys predicted it. And now all the economists are like, huh, this is weird. U.S. consumer confidence, which is forward-looking. This is you telling everyone what you're going to do in the future. And I'm going to tell you what you're going to do. You're going to take this, which is money that you don't have, and you're not going to spend it, falls to 6-month low on, you know, whatever. Fill in the blank of whatever you want the narrative to be, which mainstream media and government's going to try to scare you on whatever it is. Scare them, control them, fear, control them, scare them. The conference board index dropped to 113, lowest since February. And I apologize for that. I just had to sign in at Bloomberg, giving them $300. Thank you guys for purchasing like my courses and whatever you do to help out this channel so I can go, okay, so I don't have to have huge banners covering me. You're like, you can go around this. Yes, I do know. Web page archive. Yes, I'm very well aware of that too. The figures follow the University of Michigan because we knew this. Because Michigan was saying, it's really bad. So this wasn't like a shocker, but I guess it was a shocker, which plunged to its lowest levels since 2011. You guys are not spending. And now banks are like, they had the tightest lending standards ever. And now they have the loosest lending standards. And if you don't believe me, believe the Financial Times. Bank lending. Oop, I cannot highlight that. I can just, it's just an image. Sorry. Look at this. Woo! I had to cast for myself so you guys can see it. That's some pretty deep discounts. And also, if you understood how banks work, how money works, how economies work, money is created in the banking system. But right out of thin air, I know. Shocker, right? You walk in and you say, hello, Mr. Bankster, I would like a loan. Ha! Poof! Money comes out of thin air that you have to pay back with interest. And where are you going to get that interest? Oh, you're going to have to do this. You're going to have to keep doing the cycle over and over and over. This Keynesian system keeps everyone on the little treadmill. So right now, what is happening is banks are now lending, but people are not borrowing because you guys know what's up. And then to couple with this is for people to lend, you got to bring those rates all the way down, right? How much is a home loan now? 0%? All right, let's go buy a home. So it's pretty easy for me to, oh, you subscribed? I just want to say thank you. It's easy for me to go, oh, bonds and yields over a long period of time are going to come down because they need to. Otherwise, you're not going to go, hey, can I have a loan? And so then I come over here and I go, oh, look, watch, which the day that I talk about it, it pops up. I guess you liked that people don't want to spend anything this year. Notice the direction of which we're moving. Yes, yields are dropping. And for those of you like, hey, those are new colored lines. What are they? In my swing trading course, I don't use these lines. These are not the droids you're looking for. These are actually the moving averages when I trade crypto, which I need to apologize. Someone's like, yesterday's video on Bitcoin, someone's like, Bitcoin's going to zero. So there's the news article. And then my TA was a little weak, so I apologize. I will give you a little bit more. He's like, oh, great. I came here for the rising wedge that we all know about. Oh, but I got more for you. We're currently testing the 21, and we bounced right off of that. That's that little red line. No, swing traders, you don't use any of these. It's so easy. Also, for those of you like, wait, swing trading's so much easier. Oh my gosh. We're currently trading in a pennant or a triangle, however you want to move that. Both of those are bullish, which I still think this is here's my game. I told you this zone, but I'm probably going to wait for the golden pocket, which is right above that. That is Fibonacci levels. I just don't know if it's going to get there. Why? Because we have a divergence on the MACD and the RSI, which I put a whole lot of weight on. And when price action was going this way and MACD was going that way and RSI was going that way, I'm like, hey, kids, we're going to have a pullback. But there is your quick little TA on crypto. Actually, that'd be specifically Bitcoin. ADA, it's more bullish. But I say, don't worry about all this. I'll clean it all off. Just stick with swing trading, right? You get a sell-off, you buy. You sell. You rebuy. You sell. You rebuy. You sell. Just stick to the basics and you'll be fine. And if you are interested, I will leave a discount link down below for 70-ish percent off of my course. Take a look at it. But now back to our economy and growth and banks and credit cards, China. And you can always check what's going on over there, because usually what happens there first happens to us second. China's economy under pressure, which I've talked about. This is brand new story. As factory activity slows again in August, services contract. Not just that, they're not putting the stuff out. And so you will probably see very clean shelves. It'll be very nice and neat come Christmas time. So get your Christmas gifts now. Oh, and hold on. What time is it? Oh, yeah, it's bad time. Here we go. This weekend. This is it. Man, it is just all, it all is coming to an end. What are they going to do? Well, they're going to spend, and that's going to be terrible because we don't have an economy. But millions of Americans will lose unemployment benefits this weekend. So it looks like some people are going to go back to work. But as the statistics are showing, it's not even changing anything. Almost 9 million Americans will lose benefits entirely. Kaput. Gone. And another 3 million or so will see aid reduced by $300 a week, according to the Century Foundation. So there you go. It is, wow, that probably doesn't look appropriate. Apologize for that one. The economy is bad. Banks are reflecting that. You consumers are reflecting that. Banks are closing accounts. This is not, what's a solution? You guys got a solution? Yeah. No one does, except, hey, you guys want some free money? And if you guys think that it's doom and gloom now, oh, you wait for the future. It's like we've been playing Jenga, right? And everyone's like, gosh, I can't believe how high that's gotten. Man, and they just keep pulling the wood pieces out. They're like, oh, it's going to fall. It's going to fall. Oh my gosh. It's still going. Well, that's currently where we are at. And I'm cutting this video short, but I want to say thank you so much for hanging out to the very end, taking advantage of maybe a swing trading course, maybe a subscribe, maybe something. And I will see you tomorrow.